Yeah, that was Eddie Cantor and Vinnie Bogart. See, I got most of my jobs through other writers rather than through agents, although I did have agents. And Vinnie was in New York, and he called me back to New York from Hollywood for the Colgate Comedy Hour, Eddie Cantor. And we worked in Eddie's apartment, and his wives were, his children were all there, the wives and so. And Eddie would walk up and down in his character, and Vinny, who was a very good mimic, would also do that. And I would pitch in my 2 cents worth. So one night, while his wife was listening, Eddie Cantor said, well, it's midnight. Let's go over to Larry's hotel and finish. So I looked at him. We weren't going over to my hotel. He gave me an epileptic wink, and I said, oh, yeah, sure, Eddie, right, we're going over to your apartment. So he went downstairs. He had a dame waiting for him and so forth. The other story they tell about Eddie is that in those days, when the star would leave the room, we'd all rush to the files and read his correspondence and all that sort of thing. So with Cantor, the story is, I wasn't there, but the Cantor story is that he was out and the mail came. So the writer steamed open a letter, and it was a personal letter. And it said, you bastard, says, you got my daughter pregnant. He says, I'm going to sue you for every penny you've got. So they quick mucilage the envelope, and now in comes Eddie. And Eddie opens the letter, looks at it, they're trying to get his reaction. And he said, oh, these agents, they'll send you anywhere.